Hello guys, and welcome, good evening everyone. Welcome to this 8th. We missed one. Oh, Tusa, thank you for the host. We missed one, a couple of episodes of the Italian Dojo. So, tonight we are going to... oh, Neme, hello. Welcome. So, yeah, tonight we are going to... to see how to play Janet, be Janet, so to keep up with the schedule of the Italian Dojo. So there will be another, probably another couple of episodes during the week, but the episodes during the weekend on Sundays, it will stays, okay? So this is a double episode for this week, and Kota Sensei is with us. Let me just unmute him so he can explain us a bit about Janet. Hey Kota, hello.
Hey. Yeah.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Welcome. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Nice. So welcome again. Thank you again for being with us tonight.
Yeah, thanks for having me again.
It's my pleasure. And yeah, tonight we are going to see Be Janet. Be Janet is a good character, and I saw you using... I don't know if she is actually your new main or what.
Not really. She's my my main, my primary main, I'd say.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, that's probably the character I play the most.
Oh, nice.
And it's the pick I usually play to if I want to win. But it's a very stylish character, so.
Okay.
I also like to pick her to enjoy and try to land stylish combos.
Yeah, but how long have you been maining her?
So I think I started playing the game in 2013.
Yeah.
Or maybe around 13. So I started with Otaru and I switched to Janet maybe 6 months later.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I think the first real tournament I went to, I was switching to Janet. So I played Janet for the tournament because
she
was a bit stronger.
And did you end well in the tournament? How did it go?
I lost to... So it was a 2v2 tournament.
Okay.
I was with Instinct. He's a French player who plays Grant.
Okay.
And we lost to RNZ in the finals.
Ah, okay. Ah, okay, I see.
He was with Batmanouche.
Yeah.
And they won this tournament.
That was an actual tournament, I mean a physical one, right?
Yeah.
Nice, yeah.
It was in Lyon,
okay.
I had to travel. It was really, really fun.
Nice. Okay, so can you talk us a bit about Janet and her peculiarity as a character? She is like top tier. Even Grant is scared.
I would define her as top tier and like a glass cannon, maybe.
Okay.
She's both extremely strong and she can fall apart very quick.
Oh.
So, because there is a bug that makes Janet take more damage from combos. She has a low health bar,
Okay.
But on the other side, she has an extremely strong neutral game and offensive game, and she has cornering PDs. In the mid screen, she can keep attacking you forever.
Okay.
Like you need to take guess against her to not really to block. Overall, it's not really hard to block Janet.
Yeah.
But she will push you really quick in the corner, so you need to make a guess at some point to escape.
Okay. Nice.
So yeah, really strong. She has good setups after throw. Yeah, we cover those, but yeah, overall, and she's very stylish. Like she has double dive combos.
Okay.
Lot of stuff she can confirm super from lights.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And of course the faint faint cancel combos that is popular in this game.
Yeah.
She's the best character for faint combos.
Okay. Okay. So let's have a look at her neutral attacks, neutral game, and how to charge her meter.
So we can start with charging meter because it's really quick.
Okay.
So in the neutral you can backdash and dive it.
Okay.
Like this. The issue with this is that you move forward a little. So if I repeat it, and I'm in a counter state when I dive like this.
Ah, okay.
So if someone throws a fireball at me, I will launch into the air.
Yeah.
In counter state. And then she has this one. So she's not really good at building meter in the neutral like this.
Okay.
But you will build meter on attacking people.
Okay.
Mostly with the deck.
Okay, I see.
So yeah, she gets decent meter. P-Power everyone. I want P-Power. You will get meter that you can spend.
Okay.
Because this is in this game, so the dive kick has an 8 restriction. You can't do it as soon as you leave the ground.
Okay.
But you can reach pretty low to the ground. So when you backdash, you can cancel the backdash with the dive kick.
Okay.
So that's why if you're going to build meter like this, it's best to backdash, because if you do this, you move forward too much.
Ah, okay, I see. So the backdash cancels the forward movement a bit. Okay.
Yeah, it compensates for the forward movement.
I see. Nice.
Okay.
Okay. So neutral attacks.
Yeah, I will switch to this window.
Yeah.
That way I can talk about the primary poke.
Yeah.
In the mid range, so she has the best bomb in the game. Because if we look at it, it's a 4-frame setup, like almost every bomb in the game.
Okay.
The hitbox is great. Forward, but she stays really low to the ground, and then you can block. When I press, this is the crouching 8 you get here.
Yeah.
And when I press it after three frame after it starts, you're already really really low to the ground. So if we look at this 8, like. Some characters, for example, if I jump like this, I may not be able to hit the Dombi.
Ah, okay, I see.
Because she's too low. Or if I do attacks like this,
yeah.
They can't connect because the Dombi is too low. For example, standing C might be too low. Not standing C, but all standing jabs will be too low. So like this, it will be too low. This one maybe not, but yeah, you get the idea. She's really low to the ground, If so, it's a much a specific thing, but you know, Kane has this lance, so it's a flash kick invincible attack.
Yeah, he's DP. He's flash kick.
Fully invincible, plus 11 on block. But when you press down B, you're only vulnerable at this point, and then this goes under the this flash kick.
Oh, okay.
So you can attack him for free. You're almost never vulnerable, and he can't reach you and get counter hits on you.
Okay.
With this, and the good part is that when this move ends, so here I'm going to hold back as soon as it ends. I backdash. Okay. I get up immediately with block. Penitence. So compared, since she's very low, you will get very easy just defense from this.
Okay.
Because your health box where you can block will increase a lot. So if they are above you with an attack like this, the attack will go down, and then you stand up and meet yourself in the attack.
Okay.
So this makes it really easy to just poke like this and poke, block.
I see. Okay.
So yeah, in the neutral, you will use this a lot. You can dash into down B or walk into down B. The dash is pretty uncommon compared to the rest of the cast. Because so when the dash starts, she has no health box on the lower part.
Okay.
So the startup can go above down B inbox, for example.
Okay.
And then she takes up, so she gets up the ground.
Okay.
And when you stop, you don't have the health box on the lower part.
So it's something similar to Tzok we saw with Giga, that Tzok can forward dash and he is invulnerable to low attacks.
If someone is mashing down B like this, you can dash into them, and as soon as you stop, you get just defend really easily. And that's an easy way, for example, if you want land the she has a super like this where you need to get a just defend. So that's the way to you dash stop, and since they want to stop you with zombie, but they are not allowed to do it.
Okay.
Because you go above it, and as soon as you stop, you get a just defend. So that's an easy way.
Nice.
You can dash and press it. Without really caring much, and if you hit, you can confirm like that or something.
Okay, I see. Wow.
Yeah. So that's for the dash. So dash into down B or something.
Okay.
And while we are showing this, because it's a very common mistake when you are fighting Jeanette, is that say you want to attack her in the corner.
Yeah.
She backdash. So let's say she can dive kick. Let's say she didn't dive kick, and you see her finish the backdash, and you want to punish her, you can't, because she has no lower health box on the end.
Okay.
So here,
okay.
See, when the backdash stops, it looks like this. So to punish this, you need to attack standing.
Okay.
Because she will be like this, able to block immediately.
Okay.
For the other pokes, I think this one is great. It's fine. Like, you don't get much out of it.
Okay.
Standing jab is a bit slow, so standing B recovers fast.
Okay.
So not as fast as down B, but you can use it faster when you dash, because when you dash, there is a little stop time to crouch.
Yeah.
So it's a bit faster to dash standing. This one is I find it a bit slow, but you can poke.
Okay.
So, like we said about Freeman, you can do quarter cycle forward.
Yeah.
AD.
Yeah.
Or AC works as well. As long as you don't input the thing, you can do it like this. If you're bad at doing AD, this is also a solution.
Okay.
And then do another one for the super.
Okay.
So in the neutral, if you do this, you can prevent dash like this. Well, not Jeanette because she's airborne, but other dash, you can stop them if you poke like this.
Ah, okay. I see. Hello, Rafa. Welcome. Okay.
yeah, she's so broken. yeah, you can do the same with down B. So this is really hard to do, but if you do quarter cycle forward,
yeah,
it's hard to input it fast enough. So in the natural, you can do quarter cycle forward, down, and then press this. That way, you can quickly press the super and not have the jab come out, but you need to be really fast.
Okay.
So yeah, that's something you can try to implement to your game, and if it lands, you get this.
Ah.
Because what you don't want to happen is to buffer like this and get and have the super come out randomly.
Yeah.
That's why you need to be really quick, like this. So if you're fast, you can cancel the down B with the super. But if not, you can you can prepare a buffer with down B as well.
Okay.
So to learn, we'll talk about combo, but it's the same as Freeman. Not as far as Freeman, like this won't work. But you can cancel it. If you cancel, you can do it from max range. And if you're close, you can either link, but the link is not very useful because when you can link, you can combo like this. And okay, this is really easy to confirm, so most of the time you will want to go for this. When you're not sure, you need to be quick and you may not be able to confirm on a single hit. What else she has? So other normals, the dancing. Dancing is okay. It recovers fast. She has an issue is that she can't get combos from this range. So all she gets is specials. She doesn't get specials, she only gets super.
Okay.
After when she's out of this range, which is a bit annoying, but that doesn't make her really that weak. So what you can do with this is I will record the black Jeanette. So this is the quarter cycle forward C.
Yeah.
So D, sorry. Quarter cycle forward D, so it's called D I. When you use this, and as a cancel, it's not a combo, but here the blue Jeanette tries to jump.
Ah,
okay. Or tries to press a button, you get the counter hit.
So it's like a block string.
I can't escape. So
or no.
It's a bit up. It's not a block string. You can mash.
Ah, okay.
It's hard to...
Because you can do something that it's like a trap.
Yeah. Like you can reversal or something.
Okay.
And then when this ends, if you hit, you get a combo. So you can do another run as a combo if this lands.
Okay.
So that's a really good trap they need to respect.
Okay.
And on block, it's like the break move, the Z break is plus 11. So you can, in the corner, you can dash jab as a block screen.
Yeah.
Or mid screen, you can just go for a dive, they won't be able to jump because you're on plus 11. Or you also have this, you can feint it for more frame advantage.
Okay.
And go into the leg kick. So if you do this perfectly, they can't leave the ground. It's only a 2-frame gap.
Yeah.
So you can keep attacking like that with the feint, leg kick. It's a bit hard to input, but there are shortcuts we will cover with a bit later. The sweep is really bad. Like I think it's really slow. Yeah, 10 frames. So
okay.
Maybe it's the worst in the game. Like you can't punish Otaro's dive kick with this.
Okay. Okay.
So it's that slow. But then she has so her close range frame data is the easiest one to remember because this, and this, everything is four frame startup.
Okay.
So she doesn't have a 3-frame move, which okay. makes it a bit harder for Janet to punish, for example, ground super when you just defend, or Eris DP.
Okay.
This in close range, standing jab. What can we say about standing jab? People will try to guard cancel.
Yeah.
And wake up. So the slow character like Rock, for example, or Freeman, that don't have invincible Shoryu, you can just mash like this.
And okay.
That works for Janet as well. You just mash this. The second one is minus 2, I think, I don't remember. But the third one is plus on block, I think. Plus 2, I need to check. Yeah, plus 2. And the second one is minus 1. So just go for all 3.
Okay.
And when, if they block this, they have to keep blocking because you can go for this or dashing or something. So it's a good situation for you.
Okay.
So this is the true attack, close C. That's why you see every Janet player wake up with close C, is that it reached pretty high. So if a Janet is matching C on wake up, it's a bit hard to let me see. To jump above this move, if I'm late.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm too used to the timing, so yeah, I jump over it. But
I know.
Most of the time it will hit you. Or sometimes you jump too early and you get hit because it reaches pretty high.
Okay.
Same goes for the close D. This move. It has a good vertical hitbox.
Okay.
What's good about this one? I can record a little frame trap. So I do down B and then try to jump.
Oh, okay.
So you can down B dash and use it. You can keep dashing at them after after maybe two. No, maybe two is too much, but yeah. like this, it will catch jumps, people trying to jump like this. Like most of the casts, your close normals don't have the same close distance, so close D has a bit more range than close D.
Okay.
So if you're not sure about the range around here, close D is safer if you don't want to get this.
Okay, I see.
Close D. So she has a close C and a close D infinite.
Yeah.
So both work. So you don't have to learn the infinite because it's really hard, but you can do maybe 2 or 3 reps, and that way you can confirm to down AB into super.
Okay.
She has those 2 infinites. I was talking about this because when you're player 1, it's really hard.
Yeah.
But if you're player 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think I'm missing one. So yeah, Jeannette doesn't have a big meter bar.
Yeah.
And this move, the far C, the second one, does a lot of crush.
Got a crush damage.
Guard crush. Yeah. So for Jeannette, Otaru, and I think Otomaru maybe, character with low guard crush, you need to use this right before they go red.
Okay.
For the rest of the cast, it's really easy. You don't have to count your face because as soon as they go red, you do this and you get the crush.
Okay.
So that's an easy way to get your crush and not fail the end of the crush. And on Grant or Tzox, you need to maybe do 2 close, extra close C to get the crush with this one. But this one is also good, it can beat Guard Cancel as well because it's 2 hit.
Yeah.
And close D, it's so if you can do this, feint dash like this.
Yeah.
So you may maybe you practice this a bit with long. What's great is that if I record a guard cancel like this, so on block and on hit, I get this. Mm-hmm. I get this. So it's close D, down paint.
Yeah.
So you want to always use the down paint with Jeannette. It recovers really fast, as you can see here.
Yeah.
Don't faint, then dash. So to just tap the inputs really lightly.
Okay.
And with this, if they try to just defend, I didn't get the big recovery. Yeah. I forgot to mention something. With close D, you cannot just defend crouching. So that's why it wasn't working. If you do it fast, see, I don't get the cancel. So I get both moves.
Okay.
And what's great about this is that if they try to guard cancel, I get this. See here, I was trying to do
the infinite, yeah.
But when they guard cancel, I don't get the thing. And here for this case, it beats the guard cancel.
Okay, nice.
So that's a great way to prevent guard cancel.
Yeah.
Also on typical setup is in the corner because you will get people in the corner a lot. So you end the day kick with this. You take a small step back, and then you want to start with this after the meaty fireball because you don't want them to be able to guard cancel.
Ah, okay.
So because the close D they cannot just defend the crouching. That's the way I try to set up my guard rush in the corner, is to prevent the just defend with this, and then you can start pressuring. So if you see they just defend this, the next time you go for a low, that way you don't even have to crush them, you can just land your super.
Ah, okay, I see. Nice.
Yeah, in the corner you can do three lows and get the super, so yeah, they have to respect this as well.
Okay.
Yeah, I think for the close, yeah, Fardy. Fardy is if you want to maybe style on your opponent with Fardy and Sierre.
Okay.
But it's not very practical. It's, you need a like really good timing or reaction.
Okay.
And facing, so it's not very practical. You can poke them out if they are above you with close D. Maybe so much like Gato will do. It's not as good as Gato, but it can work.
Okay.
Works with close C as well. Yeah, that's for the...
Can you show us the air normals?
Yeah. So in the air, the best horizontal reach is this one.
Okay.
So from a jump, so this is great, it's fast, good horizontal range, good reach. So from all jumping attacks, you can cancel into the dive kick. So here I can't do anything, but instead I can do three hits of the dive kick.
Oh, nice.
So
okay.
That way you get get your damage from jumping attacks like this. So this is a combo, but you can also not do anything. And maybe dash in or something, or add a little delay to create frame traps maybe get a counter. So because the dive kick is all manual delay, so it's up to you to mix up your pressure when people start getting good at just defending this. Yeah, so that's good for the horizontal range, air to air. Then she has this one. So this one, I'm not sure how to block it.
Okay. These cross-ups.
Like if a Jeannette player jumps, so after the throw, it's a bit hard to block.
Okay.
So you try to aim it maybe a little above the head like this. You don't have to go close up, but if they just defend, most of the time this will happen.
Okay.
So it's great to avoid just defend and wake up when you're doing a special. Same, you can do
yes.
this, get the dive kick. You can combo all air normals with this super. But not on ops, not on every ops.
Okay.
So this one, as a jump, yeah, it's a really... So it's very easy to cross up like this. If you get this cross up, if they happen to block it, you can... down C for the unblockable, the guard switch for one frame, so it makes it hard to block, even harder because you manage to block the first one and you get another mix after it.
Okay.
And then, so if you do like this, you can confirm into super again. For all of the close normals like this, she can faint and use this to combo. So this gives you a little more reaction time to confirm into the special instead of just doing this. But most of the time you can just go for the special. So yeah, this is the max damage special.
Okay.
But yeah, we go over combo later because she has. So yeah, this one, they are not smash, so you cannot dive kick cancel with up attacks.
Ah, okay.
Okay. So that's something important. But with this one, you get very easy cross-ups or hard to block with the up attack. And you can confirm it to this super. So you don't get, you only get super combos. So if they are in front of you, this works.
Okay.
And if you cross up, this gives you a little more reaction time. Because this one is zero frame.
Ah, okay, I see.
So you get a few more frames to react. So yeah, that's the this up attack, that's how you get damage out of it. If you hit really deep, you can combo like this, but you're not in range to do anything, so it's not very, very good. It's mostly to learn the super.
Okay.
Then we have this. So this is an air throw.
Ah, yeah. Like
she has the air throw. So the air throw will set switch. So when they are back to the corner, if you react like this, you are now in the corner.
Okay.
She's a bit annoying, so she has a super jump, she has a dive kick, so you can try to switch side and reset the situation.
Okay.
After it. And yeah, or you can try to attack, but yeah, you're back to the corner, so it's not a very comfortable situation. Again, like if people jump at you, you can do. So we covered this input earlier.
Yeah.
Wisdom. So it's the same idea. You go for air just defense. So you jump and you maybe you can see the motion. Jump then half cycle backward.
Yeah. Yeah, it's going to be.
Dumb.
Yeah. 8-7-4-1, right?
8-7-4-1. Yeah. So that's the motion I would use in this situation because if I'm fast enough and do the same motion, I will get the airflow. So it's a very safe way to get people off you if they are above you.
Yeah.
What people do maybe on the... So let's say I'm the one that's waking up and they jump. They want to bait the close C, right? So I wake up and I press close C. They want to jump above the close C. Oops. So this happens when the blue one wakes up. The black one is baiting. She wants to jump above this. So instead, you can just react with this when you wake up.
Okay.
Instead of going for throw every time. So for the attacker, it's really annoying to be on top of Janet when she wakes up. You want to space yourself a bit more. Well, it depends on your character, but you want to get out of throw range instead. This is also 2 hits. You can use the super. So from jumping attack, it's also a cross up.
Okay.
Okay. I'm not sure why this didn't work. Yeah, you can do this. And it's quite amazing because since it's 2 hits, it's an automatic pulse, it's going to air throw if they jump. So, like if they try to jump and I'm doing this above their head, I will get the air throw probably. If not, I get 2 hits. So, against War Cancels, if you hit it like this, It will beat most Balkan styles.
Okay.
Which is also really great. And it's 2 hits, so you can react and easily and combo from it. I think maybe this works. You need to be close. Yeah, this works. So this is fine damage.
Nice.
What's even better about this is that there is a glitch. So we said we cannot cancel up attacks with a dive kick.
Yeah.
A dive kick. But there is a glitch that lets you cancel up attacks if it's an air throw. So if I jump, do a up attack down C.
Yeah.
So this is an air throw. So now I can dive kick.
Ah, okay.
So it's also possible to dive kick like this. And if they are crouching, it's really hard to block this. So maybe Jeannette is really really smooth character. But don't have a safe state. Okay, yeah, I do. So Gato is a bit larger, maybe. So if Gato is crouching, you can just do something like this. Not sure why it's not working. Like this.
Okay.
What happens? So I'm going to pick Gato myself instead and just record it. That way you can see why it's so strong. So yeah, something like that. So if I record this, see here, if you see this, I try to stand up and block,
yeah,
because I reacted to the up attack, but it was a cross up and I got hit.
Ah, okay.
It's a cross up.
Yeah. You can see Gato trying to block.
It stays in front. So here I block with front and I got a block, a normal block.
Okay.
So yeah, this is extremely strong. If you stay crouching, but it whips. That's the only issue with this, is that it whips if you stay crouching, but you don't want to stay crouching against this. So,
yeah, okay.
It's a really nasty setup.
Okay, nice.
So yeah, this, and then she has this one. It's not really good, but you can use it with jump back and air to air. I think I forgot something. Yeah, so if you hit someone in the air, you get this. But that's only with the B, jump B. So if you're going to cancel with dive kick, you probably want to use jump B.
Yeah.
If you're above them, that way you will get this juggle.
Okay.
And then, yeah, you can. So it's really hard to do. I'm not sure, my motion is a bit. It doesn't work really well, but you can wall cancel dive kick with the air just defend and hit them before they land on the ground.
Mm.
But that means you need to react quick. So here it worked. You can add, if you see my input,
yeah.
I add the C before I press the dive kick. That way, if I'm too early, I get the air throw. So this covers a lot of situation, just like a dome with the air super, but it's hard to do. So sometimes you just get, it doesn't work on set and you get this, which is not very good. But if you can do it, it's extremely strong as an anti-air, as long as you are in the Archer range.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so we can move on. We saw already a lot of things, combos, confirms into special, into supers. Anyway, a couple of things we missed were the down AB and then the AB, so the evasion attack and the top attack.
Okay. So the down AB. It's one of the best in the game because it reach really far.
Yeah.
So it can combo like this.
Oh, wow.
In the corner, you can do four. And then, so if you're not good at doing the infinite, you can use this for big damage. Same in the mid screen, you can do two like this.
Nice.
So you should always paint it. I'm lazy most of the time, I don't do it, but you should, because you can combo after the paint, so it's best to react, to not get a situation like this, where you will get punished, because it was an air reset.
Okay.
I can show you the hitbox for this, because that's what most of the down AB look in the game.
Yeah. This is interesting, this down AB. But is it safe on block?
No, this one is not safe on block, it's -3.
-3? Oh, okay.
Yeah. So -3 means it's hard to punish if it's a bit spaced. But if you just defend, you can go for a 4-frame move. So if you just defend, you can go for most down B. You will finish it.
Okay.
So yeah, here I'm showing. So down AB is low profile on the first frame. That's the same for everyone in the game. And then she's vulnerable here.
Okay.
So if you want to beat this move, you want to have an active hitbox around here,
yeah,
or very low to the ground. And on the next frame, it's active, so it doesn't go as far as it looks, but it's pretty good.
Okay.
So if someone is trying to jump at you from a distance like this.
Yeah.
You can go under most jumping attacks. So against Jeannette, for example, you can beat this one, and you can beat this one, and I think you can beat this one as well. It's just that her jump D is too low,
okay.
So you won't be able to win against this. To do this. So this is what you're looking for when you use this.
Okay.
So you low profile under them. So the key is to do it as late as possible and crouch before you do it. Yeah, I was too early. And if you're too late, yeah. So this is what you want to get. Oops. You want to go for this. It's super.
Okay.
And since it's an automatic combo, so down AB only cancels on hit. So if they block, so like I said, if I'm late, I have no risk of cancel.
Okay.
But it's not safe on block, so maybe be careful with this. But yeah, so it's really great if you're well spaced. And you can just use it early like this. If you press it early, you don't get anything, but you get them off the air. And they don't get to jump at you.
Okay.
So yeah, in close range, the anti-air is to go for air throw, and at longer range, this is a good option.
Oh, okay, nice.
And Dombi is also a good option. Like we said, it's really low to the ground.
Yeah.
So here, I can, even if Janet hits really late, so if I'm pushing, I get it. But if I use Dombi, I'm even lower, so I can beat most long jumping attacks. So, for example, Dong or Jaegun, if they are not in range for the jump A, you can use this and beat every air normals they have with Dombi. Same for Janet, but she has a dive kick. And Dong has a dive kick too, so it's not a guaranteed solution, but it's really strong.
Okay.
So yeah, we were talking about jumping attack.
We have to see that.
Oh yeah, okay. Five AB is a bit useless. Like there are no mini setups or anything.
Yeah.
If you hit with this move, it's -1.
Oh, but okay.
Not really great. You can trick people. It's a Kara cancel. So you act like you're going to use it, but you are not. But yeah, you not very good. It's just a visual trick. You act like you're going to use it, and instead you go for the dive kick.
Okay.
But if they were going to block it anyway, but you get better advantage after the dive kick.
Okay, nice.
That's, yeah.
And her top move?
The top move. So the top move. What's good about the top move? Is so I'm going to use not this one because it's too strong. This one. So if this is very easy to do, you just board cancel. See, I say that we can get easy just defend after this. So just stand up and press CD. Well, great. So if you use it like this, they can roll. But if you just defend, it's hard knockdown. So some special move or top attacks have hard knockdown property if you just defend.
Okay.
So it's great for this situation. There is also this one. That is a bit more damage, I believe. I'm not sure.
Okay.
But most of the time, this is really good, and you get the hard knockdown, so you can try to set up something after it.
Okay, nice.
Maybe the feint I can show you because it's quite funny.
Yeah.
So here I can hit during the feint.
Yeah.
And then it goes fully invincible. So see?
Okay.
See? So if Jeanette does I will try to record an example. Mm-hmm. If you do this and faint, what is great about it is that as soon as they can attack you, you are invulnerable. So, let me see if I do this. No. If I do this and then hold to block, if the Janet tries to do something, it won't be possible. Even if I do a zero frame, it's not possible. Even with the Gato zero frame, zero Kiba, it's not possible. So. If they are, I don't know, if they are mashing something, you can do this. Wait a bit.
Yeah.
So it's hard to show with the recording tool, but. And then, when you are in this motion, you are invincible, so you can guard cancel immediately. Okay. Just defend guard cancel. Or just wait for something to whip. So people like to, when you're attacking them in the corner, they will want to escape like that. So you can bait down heavy like this. Oops. And then punish.
Ah, okay, like okay.
You let them whip something and try to react and punish.
Nice.
So yeah, that's it for the dumb thing. And yeah, you were. So there is the top.
Okay, we can talk about the specials. We already saw some specials.
Yeah. Okay.
But we missed. Something.
Yeah, we covered this one.
Okay.
So
this
one,
is
the break. So yeah. The diversion is plus 11. It's an amazing frame pack like this. It's not a combo. So, and you want to follow up with you can do another one for maximum damage mid screen.
Okay.
In the corner, you can break and go for dive kick. You can break and go for better dive kick combo. So in the corner, she can probably land this. It's a bit hard. And you can do this in the corner as well.
Okay.
And mid screen, you also can use this if you want the maybe a better mix up. But yeah. So that's it about this move. The small one is the so this one.
Mm-hmm.
You can break and go into super, so that's great because you can combo into it. It's your fastest guard cancel. I think it's the fastest guard cancel along with the top attack. Maybe let me check. So top attack is 9 and this one is 9 as well. So this and top attack are the best she gets for guard cancel.
Okay.
But this break is minus. Let me check. Minus 3. So if someone uses it on your guard. Oops. I need to block first. Okay, because Jeannette is not doesn't reach. For example, Rock or Gato for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Will get a punish on you.
Okay.
And if they just defend as well, I can punish with 4 frame attack.
Okay.
You don't want to use it on block if possible. But sometimes, like here, Jeannette can't do much if it's on block. So maybe you can cancel it on block. And bait something because minus 3, they need a 2 frame move, so there are no 2 frame normals.
Okay.
So you can bait and go for the. That's an easy. The shoes hidden super bait.
Yeah.
So yeah, you can do this, they block it, and then you go for the hidden super.
Ah, okay.
And since they want to press button, you get a just defend and the hidden super comes up.
Okay.
That's about it about this move. So yeah, I like to use it when Epoch is down B. Some Jeannette like to use the top as a guard cancel if they jump up over you.
Yeah.
I like to use the quarter simple forward, but yeah, both work.
Okay.
So that's it. You get this combo as well. So if you're not confident about this one, this one is a bit harder. This one is easier. It's a little less damage, but it's easier. So then, this move. It's your BNB under special, so you get this for the bigger punish. Oops. Like this, create combo, If you want to be optimal, you can do feint dash C, feint dash C, and use it mid screen. For easier combo, you can do use T because you have less touchback. Or like this, like you do the feint and just walk. Well, that's a combo, but it can be a combo. Yeah, like this.
Okay.
So this is also possible. But if you're not sure, like just go into it with down B as well.
Yeah.
So it's a bit hard. So if you go for one hit, you can't confirm it. There is this one also. This one is really easy, it's to hit. So this one is for combo because it's slower for block cancel, so it's not very good.
Okay.
Yeah. Then there is the C version. So this is what was called back C. This one is unsafe. Minus 10. So you want to use it in situations like. Let's use rock. So this is a good fireball finish tool. So if Rob tries to throw a fireball at me, you need to be close enough and you can punish like this.
Okay, and you need the reflexes too. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so for Rock, you probably want to use the dive kick instead because his fireball are really low to the ground.
Okay.
But yeah, or maybe Marco.
Yeah.
But Marco, yeah, you need to have the reflexes.
Okay.
So you just for Marco, I just try to input it a bit randomly, and if I'm lucky, I can react to the just defend, not to the fireball, but to the just defend.
Ah, okay, okay, I see. Nice. There's a question.
Yeah.
Always Rafa. Rafa asks, how do you do the quick ABC on arcade stick with a square button layout?
So that's what I use as well.
If you give me 1 second, I will show your pad on the right. I removed the pad because.
Maybe it can help understand.
Because it, to have a bigger image, I removed the pad, but I can quickly show it.
For me, it's pretty simple. I don't use my thumb,
okay.
So it's my index. Index is this one. Is the index? I'm not sure. To name the fingers in English, but
it's
the
finger,
middle finger,
the ring finger, and the pinky is the fifth.
Yeah, so I don't use the pinky and the thumb. So my index finger is on B.
Okay.
The middle one is on A.
Yeah.
And
ring.
Okay. The ring one.
So
I use the ring one on C.
Okay.
As well. So I had to remember because I used to do it differently.
But your A button is the bottom left.
No. The A button is this one.
Okay. So you do what's the input? It's ABC or BCA?
So the input is ABC like this.
Ah, okay. So,
the key is to not press two at the same time. If you do A B then C like this, it's not a valid input.
Okay. So
you really need to do one after the other A B C quick succession. And my training trick. So you need to just defend first. So you input the ground, then press it. So if your fingers are fast enough. If you see the genet on the screen, if I'm slow, I will get this. Down A, down C.
Okay.
Or C see. So if you want to be fast, like this, if you're fast enough, you only get drum A. So okay. That's how I practiced it. And then you get the just defend and you do it. It's easier on EV attacks.
Okay.
So yeah, you block and then do the quick input.
Nice.
So it takes a bit of finger practice, because it's like piano motion.
Okay.
But well, yeah, when you're used to it, just practice getting only the down A when you use it.
Okay.
And when you get this, you're good to just do baits like this.
Oh, don't worry, Rafa. It's you're welcome. So yeah, we can go back to the specials.
This one was. So this the quadricycle back C was for fireballs or long range guard concept finish.
Yeah.
Because it's unsafe.
Okay.
And you can't combo into it. Only from this. So yeah. Not very useful. Then there is this one and the long one.
Yeah.
I think I can show you. So what is great about this one is most people don't know this, but since it's a broken character, it's invulnerable on the first frame. So the one on the left.
Ah, okay.
As you can see, it's invulnerable. And then, after a few frames, it's vulnerable again. So, you know, for example, Terry players, we have lots of Terry players, mm-hmm. and you may want to escape from the corner pressure.
Yeah.
So you can match this, if I'm in this situation. So carry player like to do this. So here I'm just mashing this, and I can escape this little gap like this.
Ah, okay.
See, so with Janet you can escape pressure like in a brain dead way.
Okay.
Just mash this and. Or match this, they are both very annoying because if they try to do something like this, you get the air reset, so it's okay for you. Like,
yeah,
they really need to stop and punish you on reaction. It's also a two hit, so that makes it a bit hard to. World console.
Yeah.
1-2. The long one has more reach. I think they are the same on block. I need to check. Yeah, they are -4. So yeah, everything is minus for our special. But if you space it well, even Gato might not be able to finish this. Like if you do something like that, you are really far away. So it's okay to be -4.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Even when I use it in close range, there are no three frame normals that can reach me. So what you're looking for is if they have a quick horizontal super, then try to not use this.
Okay.
But yeah, they both have 5 frame of invincibility, so it's great to mash if you want to mash.
Okay, nice. Was this the last special? Does he have?
No, she has. Okay, so she has two more special, I believe.
Ah, yeah, the fireballs, the wind.
Yeah. Okay. So for the fireball, when you find someone on the ground,
yeah,
you can use this fireball as a meaty attack.
Okay.
And then you can combo from it. So the typical situation is you get someone in the corner like this. You get this, and you start your combo or your pressure. It's easy to confirm if it's a hit. You can do the same input on hit on block.
Okay.
So go for the close deal like we said earlier. So you get this setup after supers. You can use it meaty. So try not to, if they have an invincible super, like for example Marco Shoryu super,
yeah,
or Grant Attendant, you don't want to use it because it will punish you.
Yeah.
But if they don't have a super meter or something, or no good invincible super, yeah, feel free to place a meaty fireball on the wake up. And it has a nice property that we can try to explain. So if you do a really deep setup, maybe like this, see the fireball, it's really deep.
Yeah.
So I'm going to show you the hitbox, that way you can understand.
Yeah.
So this is the fast one. So if you hit with the really deep with this part, it's a low attack. So the fireball becomes a low attack.
Ah, okay.
So that's why sometimes when you throw this one meaty, when you roll on wake up, you get it and you don't know why. So this is what happens. Is you get it really deep and it becomes a low attack.
Ah, okay.
So yeah, if you block it, try to block it properly.
Nice.
It's mostly for meaty attack. It's too slow to be used as a regular fireball. Like people will react and jump on top of it. You can guess maybe. They attack like this. If they hit you, you can combo after it, but it's really random. Like, see, I can.
Yeah, you can combo.
Trade and get the combo.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's about it about the fireball. And if they are afraid to jump, you can end the pressure with the fireball. Since it's spaced a bit, it will hit meaty because of the distance. So if you use it on this one, you can dash in and get a combo as well.
Okay.
So it's really plus. You can also combo with the deck.
Okay. When I played against Janet, they used the heavy version of Fireball. While I was on the ground, but far from my opponent, so they could use the heavy fireball and then jump at me and being aggressive as I walk up.
So so when they do the meaty fireball, you crouch, you hold down, and just defend like this. Because if you just defend standing, if your timing is off, you get a backdash, and your backdash is going to land on the fireball.
Okay.
So. Like if I record this, if I fail, so here I failed too early, but this will happen if your timing is a bit off. So it's best to crouch.
Yeah.
And if they jump at you, yeah, you can keep doing the just hit.
Ah, okay.
until you can guard yourself.
Yeah, because it's a difficult setup to get out from.
Yeah, because they probably did the super jump, right? Something like this, then super jump.
Yeah, that's it. Usually they knock you down, like hard knockdown, a far knockdown, or you roll up, and while you are rolling, like this.
Yeah, I think that's more or less.
And usually they attack with the jump D, which has
a
hitbox which goes down towards the ground.
So what probably, so there is a trick to get out, is to not just defend the third hit.
Okay.
Because that's a bit weird, but if you just defend, you are stuck in Bloxton a bit longer.
Okay.
On this fireball. So what people do, if you watch Japanese players, when they try to escape this, they just defend only the first two hits. And then, so I have the bad habit of just defending everything, but yeah, like this. That way you end the block stun a bit earlier, and you can use an anti-air.
Okay.
Because if you just block, it's not a real block string. It's because you are doing the triple just defend. So yeah, that's something you need to know, but don't just defend the fireball. That way you get the gap after the fireball, and that's when you can play well.
Ah, okay.
That's why I don't really use it, but yeah, it's not too bad as a setup, and people fall for it. It's annoying to deal with. Yeah, and the last special, the most important one,
yeah,
is the death kick, of course. That's what why she's what she's famous for. So the death kick, she can combo in the corner. So she can combo with this. She can combo with the quarter circle forward B, this one. I can try to pull it off, but she can combo dive kick into dive kick. It's a big arm, I can give it a few tries. Yeah, it's really hard. So, to get the combo, you need to delay the last hit. So you do the first hit, then wait a bit and do the last hit.
Okay.
That way, if you look at the black Jeannette, she's going to launch higher. I try to kick her as high as possible. So yeah, this one is really hard to do. So mid-screen, if you're close enough, you can do the finisher. So you just press D for time.
Okay.
I almost had it. Yeah, it's so hard. That's what the 8, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Another. Yeah, like this, okay.
Oh wow, okay.
Okay. Yeah, it's really hard. So that's only for showing off in real match, but it's not practical at all.
Okay.
So yeah, that's what you get for comboing the corner. In screen, you only get... So if you're far away in screen, you might need to delay the second one, because if you're too far, sometimes the second one whiff like this. So just add a little more delay to your dive kick. And if you're far, the fourth hit doesn't work. So you can end, and when you're close enough, this screen, you can use the last one.
Okay.
So what you want to do is to always finish the dive kick. So use it as close to the ground, because, yeah, maybe I can explain how to input the dive kick first. So the actual input is neutral, down, deep. So it will do this.
Yeah.
And then you can press more D to get more dive kicks.
Okay.
Like this. But if you use it like this, it's a bit slow. So if you're just starting with the dive kick, you can do a tiger knee dive kick. It's really easy if you get the timing. It's down up like this, so you get the super jump.
Yeah.
And then you press D. That's really simple.
This is similar to the dive kick, the donk's dive kick with the super jump.
Yeah, so you input the donk before you jump, and then you can dive like this.
Okay. Rafa asked another execution question. How do you get the fastest dive kick possible? Just a slower double tap? Do you mean this kind of? I mean faster. What do you mean with faster?
Yeah. So I will explain. So this is slow. You don't have the sound here, but I do, and I can hear Jeanette saying "yoo-hoo" like this.
Okay.
So to get the fastest possible dive kick, you get this cue. Is that when I do this? So this is a double tap. Here I cancel it so fast that the sound doesn't come out. So there is no sound when I do the dive kick. Here, like this.
Okay.
To do this, I use my middle finger first, then my index.
Ah, okay.
On the D button.
Okay, so you tap twice with the two fingers.
Twice in a row. So yeah, like we can see the timing. So this is the frame count. So I think I need 2 frame gap when I do it.
Yeah.
If I'm too fast, with 1 frame gap, it doesn't work. So yeah, you need at least 2 frame gap. To practice with the Tiger Knee first, because most of the time Tiger Knee is fine, like you are nice.
So, Kota, are you watching the live stream?
Yeah.
So let me just to be sure. Okay, this is the stick. So you do like 1, 2, right? 1, 2.
So there is a bit of delay.
Yeah.
1, 2. Yeah, that's exactly what I do on the same button. So that's how I tap it.
Yeah.
The D button. Yeah, like this. And then I keep pressing D with the index finger. Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, double tap to get the first dive kick. Tiger Knee.
Yeah.
The only issue with Tiger Knee is that if you want to do so, a more advanced Jeanette player, you might want to learn doing it without Tiger Knee, because there is one little downside is that if I dash, I need to stop the dash to press down.
Okay.
So that's why I started learning to do it manually really fast like this. So when I do this, I do up down. So to get the forward jump, then you have to go at least 1 frame through neutral, then down D. On my left hand, my thumb is pressing up. He just taps up with the thumb, and then. That's the way I hold the stick, but my left middle finger taps down like this. So I get a quick up-down motions. It depends on the way you hold the stick, but like as long as you can do up with the thumb and down with any other finger, you can give it a try.
Okay.
But yeah, get started with the Tiger Knee, it's much easier to get good results with the character and not spend too many hours in the training mode.
Rafa says that sometimes he feels like he double taps too quickly and only the diving part comes out, no kick. Is it possible?
That's what I thought. So let me try to reproduce.
Yeah, okay.
So here, I was only 1 frame. If you tap too fast with 1 frame gap between your taps, you don't get the second hit. You need to wait 2 frames, at least 2 frames. But if you wait like this, so this is a bit slower. It works. It's okay. Like so, we didn't talk too much about the use of the leg, but The thing is, human reaction can't react to this. Well, to this. So this is too fast. So here, you're at a range where normals won't work, but the native will work.
Ah,
so
okay.
That's why the, I don't know how to name it, but it's like you put his aura. Aura. Hmm? Like the range where you are oppressive to the opponent around Jeannette is really huge because of the deck.
Ah, okay. Wow.
Compared to the rest of the cards. So yeah, in the neutral, you can use it. Like this, they won't be able to react. If they try to poke you with zombie, you will be the zombie. Another practice thing. When you practice your dive, to make sure they are low enough, get a crouching dummy. Because if you are slow, you get this.
Okay.
The dive kick whiffs. In actual game, it's okay because if you get the next hit, it's going to hit anyway. But sometimes it's bad to have this whiff. So that's if you want to get the perfect kick.
Okay.
Yeah, so in the neutral it's extremely strong. You can alter the jumps like with the B dive kick. The B dive kick is more like when someone jumps at you, maybe you're going to try. So I'm going to try to anti-air with down AB.
Yeah.
It will make the down AB whiff. Sometimes the B dive kick will be able to finish it. Same, you can bait guard cancel that are not very good with late dive kicks. You don't have to use it off the ground like this. If you do this, it's the same situation, they can't react to this. But maybe this is a bit more predictable.
Yeah.
Then we didn't mention this is like if you're playing Jeannette, that's the first thing I would learn, the backdash dive kick. Because on block, let me get Jeannette to block. On block, here I'm plus when I do a late dive kick. So to be plus, you need to delay the last hit.
Okay.
And this is a block string. So when you do the backdash dive kick, you exchange your turn, so they are attacking, and now you're the one attacking.
Okay.
Let's say they do a jumping attack at you, you make it with, and now you are the one attacking. So if you do it perfectly, you can even punish the landing frame like this, and use it as anti-air. It's a bit hard, you need to react fast. But she's invincible, so it can be risky, but they can't react to this. If you know she's going to backdash dive kick, you can react to the backdash, but you don't know, she might be just doing a regular backdash.
Okay.
So that's what, so you try to mix up your wake-up game with Jeannette. You don't have to block on wake-up. Really, you can make them guess. She's really hard to pin down. Backdash, D-dive kick as well for different timing. If they were trying to catch the D-dive kick, and it goes higher in the air. The D-dive kick is, you can use it like on top of them. If they like to air just defend, the first hit is going to hit at a spot that is harder to just defend.
Okay.
And it will throw off the timing. So yeah, that's what's good. Yeah, you can bait stuff like this with the B-dive kick. You get the same combo in the corner with the B-dive kick. You can do the double dive, but it's even harder. So that's for training mode combos.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, and Il y a Chicken combo, like this, they kick as well, and if you get counter hit, you can juggle another dive kick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. So we didn't talk about a bit. We talked about the supers. You said that she has 1-0 frame, which is the entire super.
Yeah.
And then she has the kind of machine gun and the hidden, which is a bit different from the usual supers. Okay.
Yeah. So that's the three. So we talked about the ABC one.
Yeah.
You can use it like this. So because of the dash being airborne, so invulnerable to low.
Yeah.
It's really easy to bait down AD. If they didn't press any button, you can do the same input. So I'm doing this quickly. Like we said, this doesn't make the C come out.
Yeah.
Only. So you can combo it with this maybe.
Okay.
If they didn't mash something.
Okay, but the input for the hidden super is just defend ABC.
Yeah, just defend ABC.
Okay.
But I can maybe show you because this is not the perfect hidden super. So this is, we try to record hidden super. So here it's not zero frame. So if you see my stick,
show it again because. The connection something lagged.
Okay.
I don't know.
That's unfortunate because I got it first try. I wasn't expecting. So
okay.
Here, I did not get it this time.
Okay.
Let me see. Yeah.
Oh.
See?
Ah.
Okay. So I used an invisible special move to escape.
Yeah.
So every most of, like everyone, I believe, Lucas can do this. It's a special move cancel because it's not zero frame. So
okay.
When I do this, I have a buffer. See, I didn't have to mash quarters to pull back because it was ready before the freeze. So I just had to press B to get the special to come out.
Ah, nice. Oh. Okay.
Because the buffer stays, what you had buffered before the freeze stays after the freeze. The only thing is that the freeze doesn't let you input directions.
Yeah.
But if you mash B when the freeze happens, you get a B as soon as it ends.
Yeah. Nice.
So yeah. So yeah, you can escape it. There are lots of ways to escape this. But then, for people to escape it, they need to have a reason to, so it's good to land this super when you can.
Okay.
And then, so this one, the horizontal one, the main way to land this is this combo. We talked about it a little bit.
Yeah.
Up attacks as well. So that's, yeah, so if Janet is crouching, you can learn this as a cross-up, it's really hard to block. So this at max range, it won't connect, so you need to cancel it to get the combo. This one, yeah, and then you can, since it's a knockdown, it gets pulled in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
There is this setup. If you watch the Tanaka first to 10,
yeah,
he was using this a lot. Of course, they can match, but it's limited. So this is not a combo, that's what I meant. But here, with this setup, you can make it a combo.
Okay.
But yeah, you need to be a bit precise. Yeah, like this. It also works with Dawn B. The reason he was using Dawn A for this is because Dawn A prevents jumps on wake up.
Ah, okay.
So yeah, people are really scared of you want to guess against the net in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
And most of the time when they wake up, I also do this mistake against the net.
Mm-hmm.
I go straight into air just defense to try to escape.
Yeah.
And this setup prevents the jump and the down AB as well when you do the down AB. And then there is another setup, is this one. So if you see here, it's a safe jump setup. If I go to, I'm going to use Gato for this. To showcase this setup. It's okay. You can. Okay, I'm Gato. Tag. So you just match C. Oops, okay. So you match close C. And then press D and block. And you will be able to. This happens.
Okay.
So we talk about this for Freeman last time. So it will block invincible for your games as well. That's it for this setup and this super. Not much else to say about the super. Then there is the zero frame. We showed it, but like you should be able to punish this because it's minus, but the zero frame part is really close to Genet.
Okay.
So you might not be able to punish minus one moves that have a little bit of pushback.
Yeah.
But instead, if I were to just defend this move. Okay. If you just defend moves, you get less pushback, so it's easier to punish with the zero frame.
Okay.
But then, I like it to when I cook, I try to buffer it when I have it available because it's a true anti-air against most block up attacks. For example, if they use this, I need to record something. I can use this, but if I use this War Council, maybe they empty jump and bait or something.
Yeah.
So since this is zero frame when you use it, you are guaranteed to win. The only exception are moves like this. Wrong super. Sometimes it will trade with the second hit.
Yeah.
Like this.
Okay.
Same if you try to use it without War Council, you will trade most of the time.
Okay.
Like this. I never trade, maybe you can. I speak? No. nice. Okay, so you can use this. You discover something.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
That's only in the corner.
Okay.
Yeah, in the corner.
Nice. A couple of words on the matchups, and then we have to close because it's already pretty late.
Yeah.
So give us some details about the matchups. So she is top tier. So what are the worst character to play against as Janet, if there's any? And what are the best character to play against?
So the one I find the hardest to fight is Grant. Grant is really, really hard to deal with, because you can't really use the dive kick that much.
Okay.
Because we say this part is a counter hit state.
Yeah, this is a counter hit.
And since you want to be at around this 8 when you use the dive kick really close to the ground to get the safe dive kick and reach people with the dive kick.
Yeah.
It's the 8 where you're going to get hit by a ground dive kick and he gets counter hit, so you're going to take big damage.
Okay.
Or the Dan guy, it's the forward chest move.
Yeah.
Where he travels the screen. So this beats or trades dive kick, he gets counter hit.
Yeah.
So yeah, he's hard to deal with. But when you know the matchup better, you can really more on jam B, down B.
Okay.
But yeah, that's the one I dislike the most.
Okay. And what are the easiest? Freeman? Rock?
I don't know. I used to lose to Freeman when I started playing, and even when I had a bit of experience. So I don't know about Freeman. I used to lose a lot to the Farsi. But yeah, she has a huge advantage against those two characters.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are really weak. I think Okutomaru is also weak against Jeannette. Because he doesn't have anything to deal with Jeannette, so
yeah.
I just backdash. Maybe
he can just jump higher. That's it.
he can just
double jump and.
If you try to challenge him, maybe he will win, but like his reach is so bad compared to Jeannette.
Yeah.
So underground in the air, so you just need to space yourself accordingly.
I see.
And if he wants to jump on you and you don't have a good anti-air, it's okay, just block. He doesn't have real mix-ups, so it's okay.
Okay, I always thought that characters with the counter moves like Rock and Marco, for example, have an easier time against Jeannette because she can spam the dive kick at least.
I think Marco has a good counter to deal with Jeannette.
Yeah.
So if you use the Marco counter, he's fully invulnerable in the upper part.
Yeah.
It's fast, so it's a bit hard to react to it, especially online.
Yeah.
Because human reaction can punish it, but if you're not expecting it, you may not be able to. I really hate this counter, because if you get a counter hit, maybe I can try to show you what happens when Jeannette takes a counter hit, if I were Marco, but... So this is a counter hit state.
Okay.
So you can do the Jeannette specific juggles.
Yeah. Oh, so, wow. Yeah.
So you get. So this is like. We have invincibility turned on, but yeah, it's really huge. So if you're fighting against Jeannette, you need to learn these combos to balance the matchup a bit in your favor. So yeah, this counter is pretty fast. So it's a bit annoying to deal with Jeannette. Like, if you're not used to the Marco matchup as Jeannette, Marco will destroy you. And then when you know the matchup, Jeannette is really hard to deal with for Marco.
Okay.
So yeah, it's a fun matchup, but it's really it can fall apart really quick for both. And if Marco is in the corner, if you can do crush, he will be stuck and lose very quick. And on the other hand, Jeannette, if a counter hit happens or something, a fireball hits you, you die really quick as well.
Okay.
So, but yeah, Rock Counter is bad. I don't find it really good against Janet. Because I think Marco has a counter that is a bit... you get this surprise effect, it moves forward. Yeah. He might be going to attack you after using it. But Rock, he just stays in place and then he's free to punish, so... It's not, and you cannot react to the life kick, so you have to guess.
Okay.
But what's good is that if you just defend, it's pretty safe to use it on the as a just defend.
Okay.
Because yeah, we didn't talk much about this main game, but when you see a just defend, you can stop on the second hit. Or on the third hit, and it's really hard, and mix the timing as well, so it's really hard to guard cancel the death kick.
Okay, I see. Nice, okay.
Yeah, and then, oh yeah, no, maybe Kevin is even harder.
yeah.
Than Grant. You need a lot of patience, but Kevin is really... it's very simple for Kevin to just destroy Janet, because if Janet is in the air, you get this air juggle, like this, you can do another one.
Wow.
And then she just died from an anti-air, an early down AD, so there are no real solution against it.
Okay.
If it's a late one, you can do a deep attack, but if it's an early one, you can't really do much. So yeah, she takes really big damage against him. He can land the damage, so yeah, it's really hard to...
Okay, I see. Okay, then I guess that for tonight we are finished. Kota, thank you. I don't think there are any more questions. Anyway, in the meantime, I wanted to thank you for all of this, the dojo and your patience and your knowledge and your sharing. And next dojo will be on Sunday, and you will be with us again, right?
Yeah, I think so. We can talk about Gwent.
Yeah, we were planning to showcase Grant, right?
Yeah.
Okay, nice. So this Sunday, we have an appointment with Grant, another big character. Strong character?
Yeah, the tournament character.
Okay. And so, guys, everyone, have a good one, and see you on Sunday then.
Thanks. See you on Sunday then.
Okay. Bye-bye, Kota. Thank you again.
Ciao.
Bye.